my God.
I do, Simon.
Well, that was genius. No, really, because weirdly, it made you realize how difficult this is.
It did.
It genuinely did, you know, because sometimes you don't want to see everything. But actually, by seeing everything, it made it even funnier.
Shadow Ace is out of the shadow.
And, you know, what's great about your act is, you know, whether you're older or if you've got the mentality of an 8-year-old, Mel, for instance, I mean, did you like him?
Can I just say, I could not stop laughing. You brought me so much joy.
Yes.
Just bashing Howie's head over and over. I loved it. I absolutely loved it.
Thank you so much.
I mean, you've had 230 million clicks online before. I think you will double it with this performance.
This was better. The song choices were genius.
Yes. Everything was genius. I want to wish you the best of luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, buddy.
Oh, my goodness. First of all, you gave new meaning to the term head-to-head competition.
My best buddy, Cody, is back. And his wonderful mom, Tina. How are you both?
We're good, thank you.
Tina, his mom, played me a song he'd written. And I loved this song. I thought it was absolutely beautiful. And, you know, you're going to hear, I think, a very, very different Cody from what we're used to. Good luck. Just remember what I said, Cody. You've got to imagine you're number one in the charts right now. And you are performing this record.
You're allowed to mentor right up to
them. I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
I didn't know that we could go up on stage and mentor.
You didn't ask.
Well.
10 seconds.
is deep, but words cut deep. We gotta take a stand. We're fighting hand in hand. Hide behind your lies and your disguise. It starts with you and I to keep the love alive. You gotta change with your sensitivity. No hate, you gotta act differently. Why wait? Be the positivity. To feed the simulation, worth more than what the people say. Ignore toxic manipulation. Don't be fooled by everyone behind the scenes. On this pain, this fans, we want to scream. You gotta change with your sense of dignity. No hate, we gotta act differently. Why wait? Be the positivity.
Gravity don't make no sense when you're alone.
Mel.
Yes, I know. I'm just waiting for the audience to calm down. I've already used my golden buzzer tonight and stolen one of your teams who were very happy to be on my team. So, Cody, if I had that second buzzer, I would be buzzing it right now.
Yes.
I'd send you straight through to the final round.
Oh, my God.
Well done, Cody. You're a legend.
Thank you.
Honey.
It's a different vibe that you're giving us, and I'm liking it. Love the song, love you, and that was perfection.
Thank you.
Howie.
I also am upset that I don't have a golden buzzer tonight because I would want to steal you so badly. And tonight to hear what you can write, I don't think there's going to be a problem with this audience choosing one of the five. I think that's already just made their choice right now. That was amazing.
You know, Cody, you continually surprise us in a positive way. For you to come back and write a song and perform a song which sounds current and relevant, and you performed it with such passion, it shows what a great, great, great artist and person you are. And I'm very proud to have you on my team.
Thank you so much.
Well done, Cody.
Now it's up to the audience voters to see if you get to the semifinals. All right, are you ready?
Heck yeah.
I only have one act today.
I know who I would choose, but who they would choose, I don't know.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a really tough vote tonight.
Hello, Billy. Hello, Emily.
Hello.
How are you?
Very well.
Good.
Very excited.
You look a little bit nervous.
Yes, we are putting a lot on the line tonight, so the nerves are there, but it's all good.
Good.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Now you're going to see men three.
Here we go, guys, clearing stage.
They better be good. You've coached them.
Hey.
heaven on my heart. You can love me.
Whoa. My gosh. I honestly feel this is what the show is all about.
Simon's very lucky to have you in his squad. I gotta say that. This is one of the most dangerous, exciting, standout acts we've ever had in Got Talent history.
Thank you. Thank you.
Can I just say, this was spectacular. It really, really was. You really like this act, don't you?
Like them. I love them.
But you know what? Guess who has the golden buzzer tonight?
No, you can't.
I guess that helps the Mel B Dream Team.
Oh my God! You're now part of my team. You're part of my team now.
Why is she out there?
Billy and Emily England! Mel B has given you the golden buzzer and taken you from Simon's Dream Team. They're going right to the finals, y'all.
Whose team is it?
Mel B. Emily, how does this make you feel?
I feel really excited. I feel amazing.
Honestly, when Simon called me, the 11-year-old Emily was a little bit upset. I really wanted to be part of Mel B's team.
Oh! It's all revealed!
Oh, that's show business.
Take that!
I actually feel like I've just been dumped.
Give it up one more time! Careful, careful.
I'm so happy.
Why would you do that to
me? Because I can.
What about rubbing salt in the wounds?
Whose team are they? Mel B!
Yeah, I got dumped in front of everyone. And they weren't even unhappy.
Everybody, this is a song which is gonna be a massive hit for you.
Oh,
be unbeatable.
I wanna climb, I wanna dive into the deep. I wanna run, I wanna fly, but don't wanna breathe. Finding my love, building love like a dragon. I wanna see the best of the world, I see my feet.
Are so incredible! You like flying over three people on three motorcycles. You go higher than ever before. You are the unbeatable!
I can hardly breathe, man.
I have to say, I was screaming a lot.
How many are there of you on stage?
We are 30 people over here.
30 people and yeah. One girl. Girl power's holding her own. Yes!
Simon, what did you think?
What did I think? I think this was a step up. I think the fact that you put your title on the line to come back to try and win this says so much about you, because this was world class.
The audience is going to vote. Only six acts go through tonight. Good luck!
That was really good. That was exciting.
Oh, I love them. I would have stolen them.
Yeah, you know who he is. You know who he is.
Tip Fist. You're just gonna do your act. Baby, I love you, Tape Face.
I love the art direction of this show.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, oh, this is you? Yeah.
Yes!
Ha ha ha!
Thank you.
That was brilliant. That, you know why it was so good? We got to see you, and we got to see Simon just standing there looking pointless.
I stood there. I didn't sing. I felt like a Spice Girl.
She's back.
These judges are going at it today.
Got the dream team.
I haven't had a great night. I'm gonna be honest with you. We don't
get pulled. Wait till again. You look at yourself back at this. You're just gonna.
So, I unfortunately, Mel won't be joining us for the rest of the series, but I just want to say thank you so much for coming back
out with
for the one night, Mel. It's been brilliant to have you back.
Tip this. You really took my mentoring literally. Well done. We don't get pulled again.
Oh man, that was absolutely incredible.
It's like, what are you doing? And then you were like this. I know.
I didn't know.
Took my chances.
Is that a map?
Yes. So many times.
I've got to tell you something, Chris. I think one of the most boring acts we ever have are pole dancers. However, you've completely changed the way I think, or certainly for me, because you do something completely different. And we've seen some great performances. This, I believe, is her best one we've ever seen.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
You took us like on an intense journey and I didn't want it to stop, and there was always something going on. I don't think that could have gone any better. That was really bloody good.
Thank you so much.
I don't know why you
you stand around and you wave at everyone like you had anything to do with what she just did.
Thank you. Wish you the best of luck. I wish it was up to us, because I would say that was a winning performance, but it's up to the audience. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Thanks, Christy.
I left it all out there, and I hope that the audience saw that, and I hope that they vote me through to the...
Hi, Mom.
Hi, sweetie. Are you ready?
I'm on standby, ready for the flight.
Good luck, my love. I believe in you. I remember how it all started.
Hi, Mom. I'm back.
Emotional artistry we just witnessed.
Yeah.
Heidi, what do you think?
It's amazing how you create emotions with sand.
Thank you.
And how one morphs into the next piece of art. You are an amazing artist.
Thank you, Heidi.
Yeah.
Mel.
I don't know, I was a bit lost at one point. But there's no denying that what you do is spectacular. It just didn't get me like it has done before. And I've seen you do your act before.
Oh,
I tell you what is amazing about your act. No one else in the world could do what you can do. No one. And you never know what the story is going to be or what's going to happen next. I mean, it's incredible.
Thank you, Simon.
With this particular show, it's really not up to us whether you move on. But I am so glad that you are part of my squad, and I think you're going to move on.
I don't know what she's drinking. Let me just see what it is.
It's water!
Uh-oh.
It's water that I can use to throw on you.
Dream Team Mel B, baby, it's time to roll. Let me tell you this. If you want to be great in this world, it's very simple. Surround yourself with great, great people. So, I'm trying to be like all four of you. I guess if we're going to do a trick, if I'm trying to be like you, I thought, well, clearly we'll start with some wine glasses, apparently. So there we go. I also I have a deck of cards. And these cards right here are in what's called new deck order, which means the cards are in order. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take the ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 of spades. And I'm just gonna take them and set them in the wine glass right in front of you, Simon. I'm now gonna take the ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And I'm gonna walk these on down to Howie. Here you go, Howie. Take those cards, just shuffle them.
Shuffle?
Give them a quick mix. Take half those.
Okay.
And hand them to Heidi. Yeah. Now, both of you, just kind of mix up the few cards you got. You can put some on the bottom, some on the top, some in the middle. Perfect. Howie, hand them on down to Heidi.
All of them?
Yeah. Okay. And if you want, you can give them a quick shuffle or just pass them on down to Mel B. Here we go. All right. Shuffle them up. Do what you got to do. Look, I used to want to steal greatness from everybody around me so that I can get accolades and awards, hit milestones in my career. What I realize is I'm a dad now. Now I'm trying to surround myself with greatness so that I can take it home and share it with my little girl. Be the dad I never had, be the best dad I can possibly be. So, Mel B, take those cards and hand them to Simon.
Thanks.
Simon, you're the last one. You're gonna take a few, put it on the bottom, cut them, shuffle them, do nothing. This is up to you. You feel good? I'll take them. You happy? You good? Here are the diamonds that you all mixed up. And you know what? I'm gonna put these right here. Yeah. Simon, I'm gonna take these and I'm actually gonna spread them out so you can see the order that you shuffled them in. I'm gonna take my finger and just run it across the deck. Simon, just yell out the word stop.
Stop.
I'm gonna go straight down. Right here. We got a four of diamonds and I'm gonna reverse it. Stick it in the deck just like that. Square it up. And these cards are gonna go right here in this wine glass just like that. If I'm trying to be just like you, if you shuffle the six, I guess all I gotta do is find myself a six. But you all shuffled these cards. When I walked out here, I said, I'm trying to be like every one of you. So if you all shuffle the three, I guess I'm gonna find my three. You want an eight? There's my eight. You want a five, there's
That's
my five.
Crazy.
You want a seven, there's the seven. Man, surround yourself with greatness. Give the world everything you got. Simon, you picked one card and one card only. You could have said stop anywhere. You wanted a four of diamonds. Right in front of you, I thought, what the heck? Simon, there's my four. There's the tens. There's the aces. There's the nines. Man, it's a great day to decide to be happy, baby. My name's John Normoss. Peace out. I love you, man. I love you.
Mel B chose wisely.
Thank you.
I tell you what, John, what you reminded me of is it's not just enough to have talent. You've got to have personality.
Yes.
You've always been an amazing performer. Compared to when I first saw your audition to now, this was you at your very best.
Love you. who you really are and the hurdles that you have gone through in life and what you have created for yourself and your family and that little girl out there, you are truly a champion.
Thank you.
I love you too, and I'm also very, very mad that you're not on my team. And usually Simon hates card tricks, and not tonight, it seems.
Not tonight.
I now love it again.
I mean, what can I say? You're just incredible. Thank you for being part of my dream team. Yes!
Rock on, thanks for having me. I love you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, John. He's such a great guy. Why did you not push the golden buzzer?
Because I think it's too early in the night, and I believe that he's so likable that they're going to vote for him anyway.
So do I.
Surprise, I wasn't expecting it. I hate to say this, but that was a very, very good choice of song.
Yes.
Here's the thing, it's five acts that go through. I thought what I watched is very good, but I don't know if it's great.
What? That's wrong. Well, the good thing is, it's the audience that is voting, you know? It's not him. So please, audience, vote. You have to.
Yeah! Thank you so much.
Yeah. Mwah. Thank you, Maria. Yeah.
Honey, I'm home.
I know.
All my friends are here. And my frenemy, Simon. Hello, darling.
I love him.
I missed you, baby.
I missed you, too.
You're not in one of your moods tonight,
no,
are you?
No, I'm
okay,
in a good
God.
Mood.
Thank God.
Hans, you didn't win last time, and it is redemption time.
I'm doing it for you, I'm doing it for me, and I'm doing it for Germany tonight, Heidi. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, honeys.
This is Liberace's original
is
piano.
Is it really?
Okay, I know, that was my idea. Thank
that
you.
Is really cool. Did you do anything like that for your act?
No, but I will.
Okay, here we go.
I was just a fight when
when I was five. Raising Cain, I spit in your eye. Time has changed and now the poor get fat. And the fever's gonna catch you when the bitch gets back. Oh, oh.
All right, America, are you ready to get this party started?
Evening on Friday and that's all right. I eat a light steak on a Saturday night. Pack a bitch the best at your social booth. I get high in the evening, sipping pots of blue. Whoa, whoa.
Come on, ATT, let's rock and roll.
The bitch, oh, the bitch, oh, the bitch is back. Stone cold sober, as a matter of fact. I can bitch, cause I'm better than you. It's the way that I move, the things that I do, oh, oh.
Let me hear you! Yes! One, two, three!
The bitch, oh, the bitch, oh, the bitch is back. Stone cold sober, as a matter of fact.
Heidi! Bring in the accordion!
The way that I move, the things that I do.
I know you love it, Simon. From one bitch to another, this slump is neither here. Yes!
Yeah! Yes!
Oh, it's so much fun!
My cheeks are hurting me because you bring so much joy to the stage.
Thank you.
What did you think, Simon?
Look, if I'm being honest with you, if you can't sing, you can't dance.
Oh.
If I can't sing and I can't dance, when am I taking over your job, babe?
Oh.
Oh.
Look, it might not be my cup of tea, but we look for things that are different. And this was very Heidi.
And very Hunt.
Thank you, darlings.
Wunderbar.
Hunt.
Am I going this way?
Just come on over here. Watch your step here.
I love him. You proved the bitch's back for real.
Heard it from a friend, you're leaving town and ain't coming back. Your heart was always running, hate that it's come to that. It's barely even over, hardly had time to cry. Girl, don't you think you owe me at least a bad goodbye? Might be too much to ask, I know. But baby, before you go,
not left the building.
No.
Simon, what did you think?
Well, I love Drake, and I love Drake as an artist and also as a person, and I've said this a lot about Drake. However, that wasn't my favorite song you've ever done. And I think as a writer, I believe that you're better than that.
Okay, well, he didn't write that.
Okay.
The songs he sang on AGT, he wrote. This is one he decided to take a chance.
Ah, okay, well, this is bad mentoring. Because you are a great writer, and I didn't feel that there was a connection with you and that song, weirdly. And now you told me, why?
No, it did connect with him, and he said it. Were you connected to the audience? Did you like the song? They're the ones that are gonna vote.
I like you a lot. I think that you're authentic, you're polished, your voice is amazing. I like the song, to be honest with you.
He decided to take a chance, Simon, and this is something we talked about in the mentoring.
So this was your decision?
Yes.
Is it, Howie?
You're amazing.
Thank you.
I think you made a good choice.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You know what I think? He'll wake up tomorrow morning and go, I wish I hadn't done that.
I hope not.
But you could have used your buzzer to save him if you really believed in him.
I know, why didn't you use
it? I thought he didn't need it. I thought the audience responded.
If I was an astronaut, I'd be floating in midair. And a broken heart would just belong to someone else down there. I would be the center of my lonely universe, but I'm only I'm crashing down to earth.
Talented at everything, but I'm trying to work out what your unique selling point is. When I go out for dinner, the worst thing is when someone orders a starter, because it's like, I just want the main course. And I think with your act tonight, the main course was the end, and the starter was the stuff on the ball.
You didn't like the ball at all?
No.
Did you guys like the ball?
Yes!
You showcased everything. It's really, really hard what she's just done.
I know.
And she's crammed it all in. And I think good on you.
Howie, what about you?
On AGT, you got mad at me for pointing out that you slipped.
I wasn't mad at you.
But how about today?
That was fantastic.
Yes.
She was hanging in the air, she was lighting on fire, she was stepping on balls. You've done it all, young lady.
Thank you, Howie.
And it's not up to us, it's up to the audience.
Wow. Thank you, guys.
I've
feel like I gave everything that I could in this performance, so I really hope it gets me to the next round.
A lot of animal acts, we've seen a lot of dog acts, we've never seen one like Hurricane, where it seems like Hurricane has trained you.
Yes, always.
Simon's very lucky to have you in his squad.
Yeah, you are such a dynamic duo, and it's quite a long act for a dog to remember, and it's just really incredible what you do.
Thank you very much.
Mel, first time.
Yeah, this is the first time that I'm seeing this. And it's just adorable. You are a great example of what the Fantasy League is all about.
Thank you.
I want a Hurricane.
Since the day we've met you, you have just got better and better and better. And I really think the fact that you put your title on the line to come back to compete again says so much about you as well.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. I really, really hope the audience votes you through.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well done.
I want to tell you a small secret.
What's going on?
They're whispering stuff.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Simon, what is all this whispering?
Hello. Just when I thought things were going so well, Adrian just said to me, I had a big crush on Mel B.
Wow.
And can I have a picture with her?
Of course you can. You see, he wanted me on my team. I'm sorry you had
happened,
Simon's
happened
team.
Again.
When I was a teenager, I had a picture of me on the wall.
But you were very, very young, weren't you?
Yeah. Stop.
Oh,
they are good.
Thank you.
They're really good.
I mean, yes. Here are the Ramadani brothers, and I mean, I'm already so excited because you can see already everyone is so excited to see you.
Thank you.
I wish you good luck. Look at this contraption.
Is this your mentoring?
Yes.
On Judgment Day, I won't fade away. I'll be pushing on till my
Honestly.
Thank you.
Simon.
For me, I like to feel that we're judging this show based on what we've seen each act do before. And I thought there must be a ceiling. And you've just broken through the ceiling.
I still think you can do better.
What?
What?
I'm gonna be honest. I think you can do better.
Howie!
You can.
No, they're amazing.
Hey! 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 You can do better. You can do better.
Howie!
You can do so much better. With
oh my God!
With the right. The Ramadani brothers from Heidi's Dream Team. What do you want to say, Howie?
You'll never have to wear lamé pants again.
Ladies, these are the Mersey girls. Tell us a little bit about you.
We've all been dancing together since we were literally tiny. It's what we all wanted to do as a career. That didn't end up happening for me. I was diagnosed with a condition called scoliosis, which is a curvature of the spine. And I was told that my dance career would end after I get surgery to fix that. So we were like, let's go out with a bang before my surgery. And we applied for Britain's Got Talent. That's when we ended up getting on the show and I met Simon. And that's when he completely changed my life.
Aww. Wow.
We had the time of our lives dancing on that stage. And the next thing we see...
Every performance, you've given it 100%. You might be in with a shot tonight after that song, you know that.
The only dance after the final, and you say you've got a shot.
Once you get that far, you go, oh, maybe we actually can do it.
In ninth place is Mersey Girls.
So there was a surgery here in America that meant I would be able to dance after, but it was over in America. I'm from the UK. So Simon said that he's going to help me get that surgery. So he flew me out.
Aww, wow. Simon.
My dream was taken away from me. And in a split second, Simon just gave that dream back to me.
We'll be a dream.
I can dance now for the rest of my life.
When we found out that we were on Mel B's dream team, we were just ecstatic.
I drafted you because your story on BGT really moved me.
So can you incorporate that in your routine?
All of our dreams from a very young age has been to come to Hollywood and get to dance.
Director!
She needs to have like a low back so you see the surgeries that she's had.
This is our first time back dancing.
Okay, here we go, guys, clearing stage.
I think we've got this.
Wow, buddy. This is not your child. You took care of a human being.
He is nice sometimes. He's really
nice. I'm really impressed.
Yeah.
When I want to give up, will you be by my side? If I fall, will I fall alone? Or will you be there to catch me?
Picture a place where it all doesn't hurt, where everything's safe and it doesn't get worse. Oh my, we see through bloodshot eyes. just too scared to fight for what we want tonight.
You know, I thought what I watched is very good, and it is a beautiful story, and I'm really moved. But this stage is kind of hosting the best of the best, and I don't know if it's great.
I do have 2 metal rods in my spine.
Yeah.
I try my best.
Okay, yeah. Well, you're fantastic, and I'm very proud of you, young lady.
Thank you.
I feel like you dance, all of you, you dance like a well-oiled machine. But I do have to also be honest, you know, I find it a little bit snoozy, I do. You know, because we do have dance acts on the stage that are really like flying through the air and they
but
do
you don't
just
care
wilder.
About them. You don't know them. And you know, in other dance groups, they just get replaced. These girls all stuck together and we're like, no, you
are
coming back in.
Simon? What do you think?
I like acts who want to win, who put the hours in and get better. And that's what you did tonight. And Mel's right. A lot of other people would have just said goodbye and carried on without you. But they didn't. They stuck by you. And stories are important.
Yes.
I think you're going to inspire a lot of people. And I think the audience will vote you through for the next round because you deserve it.
Thank you so much.
Well done, Jersey Girl.
Come here, guys. How the bath feel?
Amazing.
Yeah?
I'm so excited for this performance that you're about to do.
Thank you, Mel.
But your voice is just incredible. But the story is what gets me. Like, it makes me fall in love with you even more.
My entire life, I've struggled with self-acceptance.
I've always had a passion for music and performing, but I hated the way that I look. This whole concept of the mask happened. I would masquerade my face. But I'd still be able to love what I do. America's Got Talent was the first time that I really felt validated. They just said they loved me. They loved my voice. Then live shows came and it kind of just crumbled a little bit. I had to perform from Australia, which was so hard.
Going into the semifinals, Christina Ray!
It was so heartbreaking. I think because I was on such a roll. I felt like I was finding myself through this show and it just kind of just halted.
Who is your next draft pick, Mel?
I'm going with the emotion.
Oh, I like this guy.
Yes, Sheldon Riley. Wow.
That's a good one.
He's really
yes,
good.
He is.
Oh my gosh, he looks so,
so
good.
Happy oh, for me.
AGT completely changed my life. I was a grand finalist at the Eurovision Song Contest. I've appeared in Vogue, Rolling Stone, Billboard. That's kind of why I wanted to come back as well. I think the whole world has seen me in these masks for years and years.
Are you saying you want to
I don't know. Well, this is what I want your help with, because I'm just like...
I'd love to see
your face. So if you feel like you want to maybe take it off halfway through or at the end, either way, I'm going to be excited to hear your voice.
I'm glad you're anyway, excited. I'm nervous
yes.
as hell.
No, don't be nervous. I chose him because I think people will really identify with his struggles and what he's been through. I hope he takes his mask off.
I've just spent so much time trying to visually be enough for people that maybe the talent that I have is enough.
So good.
I have to say, oh, you're gorgeous, by
you
the way.
You are gorgeous.
And I'm not just saying that. Heidi.
You do look gorgeous, and you did a very beautiful rendition with that song. I mean, you nailed it. You belted out. I loved it.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you, Heidi.
I'm blown away. Howie.
Yeah, I am blown away. I got to tell you, my soapbox in life is mental health. And the biggest hurdles that we have in life are the hurdles that we have inside ourselves. Not only did you step it up from anything you've ever done on AGT before, but I think you did something wonderful for the world. Yeah. You really did.
Thank you. I always felt with Sheldon, this was unfinished business. Mm-hmm. And your voice is so distinct. And you are a proper, what I would call, front man singer, you know? So congratulations and welcome back.
Thank you so much.
Taking the mask off in front of everyone, what a beautiful performance.
I did it, hey.
Mr. Piffles.
It's so good to see you. Obviously, he's on my team, the dream team. Heidi.
Eat it, Howie. Eat it.
I know. I would love to have you.
Yeah,
I...
well, you don't. And that's why you're going down, son.
Yes.
You're going down.
Fellow.
I just recently became American.
Ah.
As an American, it's my duty to win.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's it.
When I first moved to America, no one knew who I was. I walked down the street, nobody cared. America's Got Talent changed my life. The audience, they love dragons. You know the one thing dragons love more than gold? Golden buzzers. I got the golden buzzer from Neil Patrick Harris himself. So I got all the way to the finals, and I'm thinking, have I won the heart of America?
Taking the last spot in the top five, Paul Zerdin!
Turns out the answer was no. But thankfully, good things happen on America's Got Talent.
Even
when you lose. I got my very own show at the Flamingo Hotel. There are billboards of us all over the city. Fifth of Magic Dragon, the loser of America's Got Talent. Mr. Pibbles and I, now we're American, we want that billboard that says Fifth of Magic Dragon, the winner of America's Got Talent. Fancy League.
Oh, hello.
Wo ist denn mein kleiner Drachen?
I am.
When I found out Heidi Klum, supermodel, queen of the catwalk, Victoria's Secret model, she drafted me, I'm like, yeah, it's a good match.
I feel like look-wise, we need to, like, step it up a notch.
I'm ready.
Heidi's plan to up my performance is mostly cosmetic, so I'm pretty offended about that. But maybe she's onto something. Maybe this is a way to win.
Judges, join me on stage.
Oh, no.
People remember me getting a golden buzzer from Neil Patrick Harris. So to thank him, I gave him a bite of my sandwich. Tonight I'm here to tell you we're gonna make the greatest sandwich ever. Who's with me? We're starting with you, Harry.
Okay.
12 toasters fully loaded, son. You're gonna pick up those dice. You can use one or two. Which one do you want?
I'll do one.
Do one?
One.
All right. Roll those dice to choose a slice. Off you go. That's it. Where is it gonna land on? Dun, 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 dun. Number one. Oh, bang, number one. Harry, back to your seat. We've got white bread to start off with. Now we need a meat to go with the white bread, please. Simon, you're going to spin this wheel of meat. I hope you're not a vegan. This is quite heavy. Off you go. There you go, Simon. Come on. No, oh, look, you've broken it.
Oh my God, literally
broke it. I'll just be the little flappy thing. Okay, Simon, are you happy with tuna or do you want bacon?
Tuna.
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 I'll do bacon.
Give it up for Simon. Simon's back to his seat. Heidi.
Yes.
Do you have a pen?
No.
You're going to take the pen, please, Heidi.
Yes.
You're going to write your name, Heidi, on the little stickers that say Heidi.
Got it.
Okay, that's it. Heidi, please. Now, Heidi,
yes.
I'm also going to need a hair. The longest hair you can find, yeah?
Just yeah.
Pull it out, please, Heidi. Yeah. Pull it out. Let's have a look at it.
Oh!
Yeah.
Does that work?
Oh, you got a clump of them. That's...
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Is that okay?
This is gross. You got a few little straggly ones there, didn't you? Now let's get back to the sandwich and this cheese board. All right, pick up the darts. Give me your best shot, Heidi. Okay, I hear something. Colby, Jack, give it up for Heidi. Back to your seat, Heidi. Pick up those rings, Melby. Face those vegetables. All right, if you like one, put a ring on it. Oh, we're good. No, it's not going to bounce on the end.
Chili.
A chili. Give it up for Mel B as Mel B returns to her seat. And to choose our final topping, please welcome little Mr. Pibbles. Oh. Look at him. He's still going. Jay, spin that turntable of toppings. Off you go. Mr. Pibbles, stop one with the power of your mind. Anyone you want. Anyone you want, buddy, with the power of your mind. It looks like ketchup. We're going ketchup. That's it. Perfect. Oh, lovely. We've got the tomato ketchup. We've got the chili. We've got the Colby Jack. We've got the white bread. And, of course, we have the tuna, correct?
Yeah.
Is it just me? Or is there something missing?
Hi, Piff. It's me.
Inside the safe is my gift to you, the greatest sandwich of all time. I hope you enjoy it, Piff. You've earned it. With much admiration, Neil, the Sandwich King, Patrick Harris.
Neil Patrick Harris put a sandwich in that safe. Terry?
Yes, sir.
Get out here. Give it up for Terry. Terry, we're going to lower that safe down. Jonas, do not take your eyes off of that safe.
We're not taking Terry, it off.
Now, you'll notice it's locked with a combination lock.
Okay.
I believe the first number to be zero.
All right.
Try a second zero. Third zero. Hang on, zero, zero, zero. Zero. Oh! Bang!
Yes.
Got it first time.
Yes.
Terry, open up the safe. Is there a sandwich bag for me?
Yes.
You're going to reach into the bag. You're going to remove the sandwich that I'm praying is there.
Okay.
Oh!
There it is. Oh, wow.
Place this over here on my head.
Oh, there it is.
All right. Give it up for Terry. I'm going to open up the sandwich. Is it me, Heidi? Is that white bread like how we chose?
Yes.
It is?
It is.
Okay, Simon, do you remember what you chose to meat?
Tuna.
Tuna, is that tuna there, Heidi?
Yeah.
What kind of cheese is that?
The cheese that I picked.
Colby Jack?
Yes.
Mel B? Look, what's that? Oh, what's that just there?
Chilies.
Chilies?
Yes. Yeah. Chilies.
What?
Heidi, you're gonna stick a finger in that.
I don't know about that.
Come on, Heidi, just stick a finger in
there. Okay, it's all for you.
Yeah, sit, lick it. Lick it. That's it. Perfect. Perfect. Lick it.
No.
Is that ketchup?
It is ketchup.
Yeah. But wait. I've got to test the sandwich.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Hello.
What is it? What is it?
I think there's a missing room.
What?
With the hand. No.
My name's Piff the Media Dragon. Good night.
Standing ovation.
That's amazing. How did they do that?
No idea.
Honestly, I have never seen Simon Cowell this gobsmacked. You're gobsmacked, yes or yes?
Seriously, yes. You delivered, I think, the best overall performance I've seen from you. And you know what? Maybe this is the year you are going to win.
Possible.
You didn't just say you want to win. You came with a winning performance. You really did.
In magic, so I'm trying to. I don't even want to know how you did it because it's magic.
Yeah, I'm not going to tell you, Mel.
I wish you good luck. I hope you will win it this time.
We're going to win it, Heidi.
You're going to win it. I'm a
believer. Simon, that was the best performance he's ever done.
I totally agree.
You should have used your buzzer.
It's a strategy. I know
it's
what I'm doing.
It's a bad strategy, Howie.
Make it happen.
I'm gonna
go out there.
Let's
go.
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 Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Oh. Well, I remember this guy before.
Woo! He's always funny. I love you.
What's
I
up?
Love this guy.
How you doing?
Preacher Lawson.
Hey, what's up, Howard Mendel?
Are you happy that he picked you?
I am so. I feel like it's a golden opportunity. Well, it could have been a golden opportunity.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
I can't believe.
Actually,
I'm a comedian, Howie.
Yes.
Howie, you did know the preacher was coming on tonight, right? But you gave your golden buzzer to another act.
In the moment, I got caught up in emotion.
To be fair, they look like me with my shirt off. So that's... Every time I've been on America's Got Talent, I've been losing. And this time, I'm here to take over, okay?
That's what I want.
Showed him the laugh.
All right. What's up, y'all? Good to be back on America's Got Talent. This is great, man. Changed my life. got the tour everywhere. Got the tour. I was in England. In England! Sorry, that was weird. I'm sorry. England! I like doing that. I know. I know it's bad. I like doing it, though. England! But it's bad. But, like, you know who else does really bad impressions? English people when they do American accents. It's bad, too. They always do the same accent. I'm from America! Every time. They do that one, or they do, like, I'm American, right? Or the third one is, yo, 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 my man. I'm like, I wonder what race he is. You know, they just assume all black people in America sound like DMX for some reason. American the better woman dogs. I gotta pee, all right? I don't know how to transition. I'm just letting you know I gotta pee. I gotta pee. You ever have to pee, like, real bad? Like, you know, real bad. You at a public restroom, right? Right? And instead of it saying, like, men and women, they try to be creative. It's like a boat and a fish. You're like, which one? Everyone's walking to the wrong restroom. Every woman in here has walked in and been like, when they put urine on inside the restroom? And every dude has walked in like, is that a couch? They got a couch? Is that a vending machine? What kind of candy is that? That's some weird candy. They got lotion? Why they got lotion inside the restroom? Can't have a lotion in the men's restroom.
Oh!
Yeah, you know, because we're not gonna use it. It's a waste of lotion. What are y'all laughing at? What were y'all laughing at? It's funny, because women are cleaner than men until it comes to your restroom. I went into a woman's restroom, I seen pee on the toilet. Like, I expect that in a men's restroom. Fellas, how many times you walked in the restroom and you seen pee on the ground immediately, right? Who's that guy walking in? Oh, man, I was so close. There's always some old dude peeing 3 feet from the toilet. It's like, come on, man. We all know you don't got that much horsepower. But women are funny. Women are the only people that go to the restroom in groups. You rarely see dudes. I got to pee, Brandon. Let's roll, brother. Should say something. Let's get out of here, man. Where's Tyler at? Tyler here? Yeah. All three of us, we can go together, you know. Hopefully they got a couch. You know, we can take selfies. That'd be awesome. That'd be nice. Is that lotion? My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. Y'all are awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, my God. Channing O. You got jokes. You got charisma. I don't have a golden buzzer anymore.
You don't!
But I got a feeling you're not going to need it. I got a feeling that you're going to be one of the six that go through tonight.
Thank you.
I feel like this was the funniest set ever. Not even just from you, from anyone ever doing a set.
Oh, you better stop, girl. You what?
The only way you can judge this is, did we laugh more? And the answer is yes.
Yes!
That is what I would call a winning performance. And I really like you.
Yes, we love you.
Howie's my hype man. I appreciate that.
I love you, buddy.
I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant. That was so good. You were so good. You think you're going to vote for him?
Oh, yeah.
Look, man, I want to win it. So I did all I could do. And hopefully that's enough. And then they vote me through.
Try this at home, y'all. Please. What is going on?
What did you think?
What you did, I thought it was okay. Up until you took the sword on sword, if you fall, your entire face
exactly.
is impaled.
Yeah.
That took it to a whole new level.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Simon?
I think, you know, because we had a not dissimilar act earlier on who just had more levels.
But it's very different, those acts.
It is
acts.
Different.
I know.
Very different. They but didn't balance on swords.
Look, I think you are really, really, really talented. However, I think in this show, you got to step it up from where you were before. I saw you on Britain's Got Talent, and I don't think that was a step up. But it's not down to me.
You won't see that anywhere else apart from on my team with those guys. So make sure you vote for them because they deserve it. Thank you so much.
Thank you really much. Thank you.
I don't think they'll go through.
Oh, don't be jealous now.
I'm
don't be nasty. It was great.
Wow.
Thank you.
This is great.
Welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi. I'm good.
Good.
Well, okay.
The first thing I want to say
okay.
is Wes is very nervous.
Oh, very nervous. Yeah, I'm very nervous.
Well, look, I don't want to give anything away. So, good luck.
He's sweating. Simon,
well, he's nervous.
Sweating.
But why is he nervous?
Because he wants to win.
That means a lot. On a sword.
Well, you'll see. It's very dangerous, this act.
10 seconds.
Let's see what your mentoring has done.
Shh, shh, shh.
Okay, here we go.
Come on, Wes. Come on, Wes.
Girl, look at that body.
You kidding?
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out when I walk in the spot. This is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got to watch it in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
You think the guys with the swords are dangerous? Look.
Oh, wow.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out.
Sexy and I know it.
Now the big finale.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Got quite emotional. Listen, I think Mel is just being over competitive, didn't need to buzz you, so why didn't you like that?
I did need to buzz because I've just wasted, what, 4 minutes of my life that I'm never gonna get back.
Really?
I didn't, yes, really.
Really? Eh?
Really, really. So you would pay to go and watch it, you know what?
People love him.
Yeah!
Thank you.
At the end of the day, you know, we just had two guys balancing on swords.
And you
and
don't
then
think that was dangerous at the end?
That none of it was dangerous.
Really?
Really, yeah.
Okay. All right, which is because you didn't get him on your team. Howie.
Simon obviously worked with you on the nipple tug.
Tr-
trust me, when you see this back on TV, it's going to look a lot better.
Yeah, but this is the voting audience.
Yeah, and, well, true. Yes, but these ones are going to love this show.
I don't know about that. We have audience right here, and they're not sure about it.
These don't like
they
it.
They did.
No, they did not.
Well, these ones loved it.
No, they shook their
heads.
Can
I just say something?
There's nothing that you can say to make people vote.
He has spent 2 years preparing for this performance. He's flown a long, long time to be here. He's emotional. He wants to win. And yes, it might not be your cup of tea, but we look for things that are different. You're unique. You're funny. And I really like you.
I love you, USA, America. Yeah. This is true. This is true. America, I love you.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Arigato.
That was better than the two guys with the sword and the girl with the ring.
Different level.
People nearly killing themselves and then that.
Lauren.
Hi, Simon.
How are you?
I'm so good. I'm just over the moon right now.
Tell everybody who you are and where you're from.
I'm Lauren Allred. I'm from Brooklyn, New York, and I'm a singer.
One of my favorite movies ever was The Greatest Showman. Mm-hmm. And one of my favorite songs in the movie is the song Never Enough. And then I found out, actually, the girl who sings the song in the movie wasn't singing the song. It was actually Lauren's vocal.
Oh, that's crazy. That's crazy.
Growing up, music's always been a really big part of my life. My parents are both music teachers, and I always loved to sing, and I would sing in my room for hours and hours and hours, but I was too shy to do it in public. When I was around 24, I had been waitressing for a while, and then I met the songwriters for the movie The Greatest Showman. They said, you know, we have a song, Never Enough. Can you come in and sing the demo for it? So they can show it to whoever they want to sing it eventually. I went into the studio and I sang the song, and then they said, we're thinking about having the actress lip sync to your vocal. And I just thought, oh my gosh. I was so excited to just have my voice be in the film. I felt so proud because, you know, people were hearing my voice and that's what I had dreamed of. But people didn't know that I had sung the song in the movie. So when they heard me singing, people would say, "You sound just like the movie. Wow." And it wasn't really until that moment that I thought, I need to just go for this. But I wasn't really ready for a stage like America's Got Talent. And so I decided to go on Britain's Got Talent to get my feet wet. Some of you guys have actually heard my voice, but you don't know my face. I sang the song Never Enough on The Greatest Showman.
Oh my God!
I went on that stage and I did the scariest thing for me. I knew this moment could be make or break it for me. It just felt so validating. It really was a dream come true.
Lauren Allred, you are not in the final three.
I did not win, but I faced my fear. And I was really, really proud of that.
You know, I was actually very starstruck.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for me, this is almost like being in a movie right now. I really think you should sing Never Enough. Let's do something unbelievable where everyone goes, oh my God, I've never heard that version before.
Yeah. This version of Never Enough is brand new. I think it's a step up. I'm going to be testing my vocal range. I'm 34 years old, and I just felt like if I don't give this one more shot and be fearless, then I might regret it. I have big dreams. I want to be on Broadway, put out my own albums. And I feel like if I just knock it out of the park tonight, then maybe those dreams can come true.
Come on, Lauren.
I'm trying to hold my breath
Let it stay this way. Can't let this moment end. Take my hand. Will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough.
I mean, that's amazing that such great talent is so not known and behind the scenes, and so wonderful of you to bring it forward and introduce it to the world.
Look up, 'cause here I come.
I mean, how lucky are all of us right now that we got to witness this live right in front of our eyes? It was just absolutely beautiful.
Thank you so much, Heidi. Thank you.
Mel.
I'm actually lost for words, because that is just amazing what you can do.
Thank you so much. I'm blown away.
That was honestly spectacular. And to have that moment almost taken away from you.
Yeah.
And no one knows it was you, and now you've got the guts to come back on this show and tell America, this is me, is so special. I really hope that America get behind you and give you the break that I genuinely believe that you deserve, because you are an extraordinarily good artist.
You know, there was a while when I was more comfortable singing behind the scenes, and I thought maybe that's what I was meant to do. And
no,
until
never, no,
until
no,
now,
no.
You know, I'm ready and I'm here, and thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Another amazing act.
Simon's dream team has been to leave. Simon has not missed.
Are you ready for your time to be in front of the camera now?
Yes, I've never been more ready than now.
I don't know how this audience is going to pick five acts.
This is insane.
It
because
is
they're
insane.
All so good.
Yeah.
I have a feeling there's going to be some surprise. Hello, ladies.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
So good. How are y'all?
I'm so excited that you're here tonight.
Before coming to AGT, there was a lot of no's and a lot of closed doors. And
A lot.
And a whole lot.
We've been trying to break into Nashville for the last couple of years. It's been kind of hard when I think country music doesn't always look like us. Well, you can have him too.
Somebody get out your seat tonight. You may have just broken down the door with that performance, trust me.
We look up and we hear Simon counting down. And
five,
when we see
four, three, two, one.
It felt like the world made sense. It felt like America got us.
Things are gonna go very well for Chapel Hill.
I remember having that hope that, like, we really could win.
Chapel Hill, you made the AGT final!
We decided to do our original song, American Pride.
But singing a song that meant so much to us, the walls had come down. We just left our hearts out there.
We just cried throughout the entire performance.
Some of the vocals were off, and maybe because you were emotional and because there was a lot of pressure.
It was hard. It was hard to have to face that you won't be winning at all.
Soon as we found out that there was going to be a fantasy league, we were like, we don't want to get anybody but Simon.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Simon is the ultimate group mentor.
If you want my honest opinion, I think you should redo American Pride properly.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's such a risk because if the world has seen you fall on your face once, do you really want to try it again?
These songs are a hit. Mm. It really, really is a hit. And, you know, I think the song needs a big ending. Mm-hmm. But most importantly, people have got to listen to the lyric of that song. America chose you for a reason.
To be back and be on your dream team is everything to us, and we're excited to give this song another chance.
Shot. Okay, here we go. Grab your seats, please.
We feel like this is our moment of redemption. Simon is the secret sauce that's gonna bring this all the way to the top.
God, I feel very nervous.
Good. That means you care.
I do care. I really do care.
5 seconds, four, three, two.
I grew up in America at a time that wasn't so bad. We were raised out in Steep Holler, did the best with what we had. We had it all, loving neighbors, land, and freedom. And that's what built me. In my American pride. So I know that we can do this. Hold hands and step aside. Let love pour out between us. Move the hate and let's just try. I believe we'll make a difference. One person at a time. My American bride. So I pass the love around. Some lay their own lives down to fight for you and me and for this nation and this land and your right for freedom. Just try. I believe we'll make a difference.
salvation.
If you need the love that's true, need someone to stand by you.
Wow. That was a moment.
All right, Simon. I'll give you that one, Simon. All right, all Whoa. Right.
Mel?
Well, I mean, I could just tell how much you want this. And the energy coming off that stage. Everybody got out of their seats. And that's saying something. I loved it.
The fact that you sang that song again, and we are living in the times we're living in, I felt like that was an anthem.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only five acts can go through.
Yeah.
And I want you to be one of them. But it's up to the voting audience.
Chapel Heart, you are a fan favorite. You're one of my personal favorites. Love you, girls. I also love the way you look today. I know that he had nothing to do with that. You look absolutely beautiful.
Thank you so much.
This tonight was about redemption. And you know what? You absolutely nailed it. I've got to know the ladies pretty well, and I can tell you this. They are sincere. They've had not an easy time getting the Nashville to get behind them, but you've never given up.
I just want to say thank you so much for seeing us and believing in us and believing in us enough for us to come back to do it again. And we just want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
I really pray that the audience get behind you and put you through to the next round because you deserve it.
Thank
you
so much.
Wow, that was incredible.
Oh my gosh, you were right again.
I love them.
That's Simon's dream team right there.
I love y'all. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Is this Sophie Darcy? This is contortion on steroids.
Who's mentoring Sophie?
Heidi.
Oh my goodness. Sophie Darcy.
That was my pick. Yes.
That's a great choice. The first time we saw you, you were only 14 years old. How old are you now?
I'm 22 now.
Oh my God, all grown up.
My name's Sophie Darcy and I'm 14 years old.
What is it you're gonna be doing for us today?
I'll be doing hand balance and contortion. I had discovered a YouTube video of a contortionist and thought it was really cool. I'd watch these videos over and over until I got those moves just right. I just kept teaching myself at home and it became an obsession with me. I was so young, I was so new to everything.
What planet are you from?
I always watched America's Got Talent and never would have thought in a million years it would change the rest of my life. I've had so many doors open up for me since. I started a YouTube channel that has almost 10 million subscribers. I've even released my own music and guest starred on some TV shows. But when I found out I was chosen for Fantasy League, I was so honored. I felt like I had to make America proud. And being on Heidi's dream team, I'm so excited.
Hello!
I've been a fan of her since I first saw her. I mean, when you look at her on all her social media platforms, she's become, you know, really like a superstar.
What is this?
So gorgeousness.
These are my designs for bodysuits.
You actually drew these?
I drew these, yes.
You're good.
This time I'm really taking it to the next level in the sense of danger. Ooh. And
would you be surrounded by fire?
That,
you know?
I mean, that could really be cool too.
Yeah.
Let's smoke this place up.
Okay, here we go.
I want to show Heidi that she was right to pick me for her dream team. This time, I'm here to win. Nervous.
lived in it either.
Very superstitious.
Jesus. That's good.
Very superstitious. That is bound to fall. Superstition ain't.
Listen, this is competitive, and I don't like to give my fellow mentors credit.
But keep it coming. Go on.
But if tonight was my golden buzzer, I would use it on you. I definitely
would. Thank you. I think I'm going to have to agree with Howie, because that looked very well rehearsed and slick.
Well done. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so I felt actually quite emotional, Sophie, because I'm seeing you grow as an artist and have the guts to come back and compete again against some of the best acts in the world and actually get better.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much.
I have a feeling this might be your year.
Thank you so much.
Everything, and I don't want anyone to kerfuffle this, as Mel would say. I will give you this golden buzzer.
No way!
Right now.
The dreams come alive.
There's only five spots left.
Sophie Dassey, you are going straight to the AGT Fantasy League Finals!
This is so
insane. I mean, I'm like speechless right now. I don't know what to say.
I want to say that you did not really actually need my golden buzzer, but you know, I push it for you because I love you and I believe in you and I think you're amazing.
That was great.
One more time for Sophie Dassey.
This girl's great.
I yes. wanted her on my team. I did.
I know, but I got... Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, everyone. This is Ank Erdin from Mongolia. And yes. he has won Mongolia's Got Talent.
Тэг миний мөрөд маань дуучин болох байсан. Тийм болохоор би яг авьяаслан монголчуудад 2016 онд орчихсон.
Heidi, your turn.
Come to mommy.
Uh-oh.
Oh, don't, Heidi.
Whoa. He is good.
Did you want this one,
Yes,
Simon?
I did.
He's amazing.
Mongolia's Got Talent, the winner.
How are you? I chose you because your voice is amazing. And because also you're a winner. And I like winning also. Are you a little bit nervous?
Yes.
Yeah. So I think it's important to project because you have a star voice.
Мэдээж тайзан дээр гарах бүрдээ баг ямар нэгэн байдлаар жижиг том байдлаар сандардаг. Миний хамгийн том үйл бол дижиталхийн хэмжээний одолох. Энэ бол миний боломж хөшүүрэн маань болж өгч байна.
Did you mentor in Mongolian?
I've been to Mongolia. I went
That's
to the
not what I asked.
No, I didn't.
Okay, here we go. 10 seconds. 6, 5 seconds.
And I got friends in low places where the whiskey drowns in the beer. Jesus, my blues away.
Is that coming out of him?
And I'll be okay.
I was not expecting that from Mongolia.
Blaming on my roots, I sure them boots, ruined your bright time fear. Last one knew, you last one to show. I was the last one you thought you'd see there. And I sound a surprise. Fear in his eyes, and I took his glass of champagne. And I tasted you, say, don't even make it through. But you never hear me complain. Cause I got a friend in low places where the stay grounds in the field traces my blues away. Think I slip on down to the oasis. And I got friends, love places.
That was good.
With a smug face.
I mean, how amazing is his
wait,
voice?
Wait.
Yes.
Wait.
What?
I don't know. I feel like Mel B. I'm confused. Was he lip syncing?
No, of course not. No one can lip sync on American.
Were you lip syncing?
No. Don't judge a book by its cover, Howie Mandel.
How would you even know this kind of music? How did you get into this kind of music?
It's called the internet.
You don't find this amazing?
Yes.
Of course, that's why
but
he is on my dream team.
I'm not surprised. This is exactly what this young man should be singing.
Yeehaw
because
to
your
that.
Tone is stunning. Absolutely stunning. I love this performance.
Yes, love.
Thank you.
What I would like to have seen is for the music just to stop and for you to do like an a cappella. Because I need to hear this guy sing.
Do you know what? Can I say something? Maybe next time you start a cappella.
That was my idea, Simon.
Not now, it isn't.
I think
the track comes.
Do you know what?
Doesn't matter, it was brilliant.
Thank you so much, you were amazing.
Thank you.
I really want to hear his voice.
Maybe if he did some a cappella.
What? I'm gay. What?
Go! Let's go! That's what we're talking about. Hi, Perry. How are you?
I'm feeling so good right now. I can't wait for this one.
Every time I think of you, I think this would make the most amazing Super Bowl act.
That means a lot. Thank you. When we first came on this show, we were just a bunch of kids from Chicago looking for opportunity. But now, after a year performing in Las Vegas, performing with the Chicago Bulls, performing all over the world, we know one thing. We coming into this competition to win.
Yes. I like that.
That's it.
Okay. Just do your thing. This is power.
It is.
Power.
You really fired them up.
Yeah, I did.
That is a Super Bowl moment right there.
Thank you.
That is better
Thank you.
Than anything you have done before on the GT stage.
Thank you.
And you are, in my mind, tonight the one to beat.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm actually really annoyed at myself. Because you're on Simon's dream team and you just killed it!
Thank you. I appreciate that.
There are occasions, you know, with an artist where you look into their eyes and you see steel. That, to me, is the sign of a fighter and a star. There are other artists who are favorites to win, but I have a feeling that you are going to surprise everyone and win this whole show.
Wow.
It's been an absolute honour, and I could not be happy. I feel like a proud parent right now.
Simon,
I do.
All right.
I do.
Thank you all so much.
Come on now.
Thank you so much.
He believed in us, he had that love for us, and we was able to make you proud. We're ready for more. We can't wait for the next round.
Interesting. I like those, you know, the David Attenborough type of things. So, look, it is incredible, but then I'm thinking in the context of a Vegas show.
Right.
Which is, are you going to sit there for 2 hours and listen to a frog?
No, but she does so much more. I think it's great. Mel?
I was confused because I didn't know what animal was what. I think I would have liked to have gone, right, this is now an elephant, or this
there
is now...
There was no elephant.
There was drum, drum, drum.
What is wrong with both of you? A frog and an elephant. Oh, my God.
But, Howie, I think you have to take this as a note, and maybe you need to approach your mentoring a little bit differently.
Yeah. I totally agree.
Yeah.
They don't understand animals if it's not a dog. It's like a soundtrack and animal sounds and music and singing come out of one person. You took me off to the rainforest. I loved it. Thank you, Genevieve.
Thank you so much.
Whether you guys like this or not, my act, it's not up to you. It's up to the audience.
Wow, well, I think they're gonna...
Making paper airplanes reminds me of fond memories. Well, as we grow older, our memories fade with time.
It's gone.
Memories are invisible. What are the most precious things in my life?
Celebration, hip, hip, hooray, love. Photographs and see.
stacked against us both.
I was excited.
Say it.
Obviously, being Yu's mentor, it's special.
You're not his mentor.
You're not.
We have a connection. You've developed this very cool, laid-back, Vegas-style persona, world class.
I agree. Now,
you're not just cool, you're kind of very slick and very confident. I love how you are with it all. It's like, yeah, I can do this, yeah, I can do that. Good.
Thank
very
you so much.
Good.
Howie!
That was the best magic act I have seen in the last 5 years.
That's saying a lot.
And the ability to rise to that level working not even with your mentor of choice.
I know.
Good point.
Listen, I see the Heidi in there. I've said this a couple times tonight, only 5 acts can go through. I promise you, you are going to be one of the 5.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I smell some more Team Howie coming out.
Howie?
Mm. And I watched something that you watched and judged on BGT this year. One of the most viral moments because I looked at the numbers. I think this is inspirational. I think this is motivational. I think this is going to blow you all away.
After this, can I take a commemorative photo?
Okay.
My name is Ichikawa. I'm 43. I'm from Japan. And I'm a semi-finalist on Britain's Got Talent.
I'm a wind musician.
A wind musician?
Yeah.
BGT で最初にステージに上がった時は人生で最も緊張して最も興奮しました。
I didn't know what was going on, and then I understood.
最後にはサイモン、僕と抱き合ったんですよ。涙出ましたよ。チャレンジしたんですよ。それがセミファイナルで。
Ichikawa, you are going home.
もう人生が終わった。もう無気力状態でそういう気持ちになってしまいました。失意のどん底で日本で暮らしていました。そしたらある日電話が鳴ったんです。
Ichikawa.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Howie.
Howie, yeah.
What you do is going to leave America in awe.
America? Can I go to America?
Yeah, you're coming to America.
Whoa!
Second chance.
Ichi, to have a gift like you have, it's not a talent that we have ever had on our stage before. When you go out there, just don't be nervous. Just let it go.
日本にこういう言葉があって、アメリカンドリームっていう言葉があるんですよ。まさにそれだなと思ってます。
ありがとう。Thank you。
Oh, my God.
Soap bubbles.
Soap bubbles. Simon, no, Simon, go
no,
on up.
No.
Simon.
No, Pina.
It's your act.
Your Mel. Act.
You're the mentor.
Mel.
Howie.
Heidi.
Howie.
I'll do it.
Thank you. Please come here, please. Howie, gracias.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What are we gonna do with the big balloon?
Sit, please.
All right.
And wear helmet, okay?
All right, safety first.
Yeah.
All right. Please, everybody.
Howie?
Ishikawa?
Don't move!
Oh, that's a dart?
Oh, no.
Young man, put the F in artistry. You can win $250,000 with that talent. Heidi.
It didn't stink.
No, sir, ma'am.
I've seen you online. You've blown candles out before on a birthday cake. But yeah. This, dangerous.
Heidi, no, boss, dangerous again. You got to take another.
Heidi, we will be at your birthday anytime you want. He can help blow out the candles.
Good idea.
I'm glad nobody lit a match.
Mel.
No.
Oh.
Just a moment, please.
Wait. This is for you, Mel.
Present for you.
Oh, hell no.
Look, I always like acts that are the best at what they do
right
in the world.
Yes.
Is there anyone who does that better in the world? Arguably, no.
What is wrong with
you?
I'm
just saying.
This is disgusting.
Well, it's not easy. All right, thank you very much again.
We didn't do that. Did you like it?
No.
You are the best at what you do.
Exactly.
Thank God for that.
Hello.
Hi, Fritzy. Fritzy's only 15 years old. Fritzy, tell everybody about yourself, like where you're from and what you've done.
My name is Fritzy. I'm from Indonesia, and I'm a top 5 in Indonesia's Got Talent.
I realized that I have special abilities when I was 7 years old. I discovered that I could influence people around me and I can hack into their minds. I made it all the way into the top five of Indonesia's Got Talent.
You got 4 yes.
Thank you. Ta-da.
Ritzy, how are you?
People love magic, and I think this is exactly what my dream team needed. The reason you're here is America chose you. You have over 40 million people all over the world that clicked on you on social media. Who is that?
I will tell you in this stage.
So you don't want to, you want to surprise me?
Yeah, I want to surprise you.
Okay, so can I help you in any way? Do you need anything from me?
Yes, I need your advice.
My advice is involve the judges. Just be yourself.
For this performance, I'm going to hack into the judges' minds. I'm going to use my skills to win.
This is my friend. He's been my magical sidekick since I was 7. We're best friends. Say hi to everyone. I guess he's a little shy. May I join with you?
Yes.
Howie?
Yes?
Do you believe that my friend can tell you his name?
Yes.
Okay, now close your eyes.
Okay.
Try to focus and connect with my friend. My friend will tell you his name. You got a name?
I did.
Okay, now open your eyes. Write the name and then turn the pad over.
Okay.
Don't show to anyone.
And what?
Show it to
turn
everyone
the pad
and turn
over.
It back over.
Show it to everyone?
You're the mentor.
No, don't show to anyone.
Oh, don't show it to anyone.
Yes.
Did you mentor this act or not?
It's over. It's turned over.
Thanks, Howie. Everyone, let's give Howie a hand. Heidi?
Yes?
Do you believe that my friend can read your mind?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay, let's try then.
Okay.
Can you sing one color?
Mm-hmm.
Are you done?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's say it together in a count of 3.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Red.
Red? You choose red?
Yes.
Oh dear, my friend is a bit jet lagged. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Melby. Can you please check my blindfold? Make sure it's legit.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And Simon, can you hold onto this doll?
Yes.
Thanks. Okay, Simon, in a second, you will throw the doll into the audience.
Anywhere?
I'm covering my eyes to connect with my friend. Simon, please throw it.
They have it.
Hello.
Hi.
What was that? Okay. Are you wearing a navy t-shirt?
Yeah.
Are you wearing glasses?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Nah, that's wild.
Thank you. Oh. Howie, you wrote down my friend's name earlier.
Yes, I did.
Now, for the first time, can you show us the name you wrote down?
Yes. I wrote down my name backwards.
So...
Iwa.
Iwa?
Iwa.
Iwa?
Okay, Iwa. I just got my friend a name necklace yesterday.
Yes.
So, the name is...
That says Iwa.
And Heidi, look, it's your color.
I know, it's red.
Purple.
Love it.
My name is Ritzy. Thank you very much.
Love it. Yeah.
Yes. You can check it.
Wow, look, it's red and it says Iwa.
Show me.
It's
Why did
red.
You have to pick such a complicated name?
That was fantastic. You're only 15
Thank
years
you.
Old. It's your first time in America. That was magical. What did you think, Heidi?
I liked it. I mean, I was confused at times, but we got there.
I mean, you as a person, you're so adorable and you're so cute, but I think this act was a little bit small for this stage. And I think what you can take from that is think even bigger and better.
That's good. That's good advice.
Simon?
I think because we've seen so much amazing magic over the years, this didn't have that wow moment.
What?
I think you got the wrong mentor, if I'm being honest with you, Pritzi. I think, look,
what?
This is, I get it, you're 15. It still works.
It did.
Yeah.
But there's only 5 acts that are going to go through to the next round. So good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Wrong mentor?
Terrible mentor.
You, as the mentor, shouldn't have been the person, because it looked like you rigged it.
Set up, yeah.
I didn't rig it.
It felt like a set up.
I would agree. And she's only 15. You're how old, Howie?
Stop.
Okay.
Oh my God, guys, that was just fantastic!
I did actually ask Mel, you know, did you have anything to do with the music? She said yes. And obviously, when I heard the second track, your ego is out of control. I think this is like the only dance group I've ever seen in the world who do what they do,
yeah,
which
exactly.
Makes you stand out, and that's important.
When you do a flip and you land on those heels, it's insane. How can you land on those heels?
It's amazing. I wish you the best of luck. I wish it was up to us, but it's up to the audience.
Team Mel B! Team Mel B!
I love you guys.
Thank you so much.
I have to give it to you now.
Come on over here. Come on over here. Yeah. Yeah.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
This is Heidi's team, Simon.
I know, I'm just saying welcome.
I know, he's just very excited about everyone who's on my team.
I said you're doing well.
I know, I am.
You are.
You're a little bit jealous. And I'm very excited. This is Darcy Lynn, everyone!
I was literally only 12.
My name's Darcy Lynn.
When I stepped foot on the AGT stage for the first time.
melt.
Mel B giving me the golden buzzer. It was honestly one of the most incredible moments of my life, but winning was just like out of the question.
The winner is Darcy Lynn!
It was incredible. It's kind of hard to put it into words. And now I've gotten to do so many awesome things.
Darcy Lynn and Friends Live.
I remember seeing like J-Lo's poster up in Vegas and then like mine right next to her. And I was like, that's not real. Like that is super cool.
Heidi Klum, who is your draft pick?
No,
go.
No,
oh, yes.
No, that's my golden 14 buzzer. Seconds.
I know, this was your golden buzzer.
No, I knew I should have picked her first.
Now she's with me.
And I thought you were friends, you said.
I am your friend and I love you, but now this is game time, babe.
Darcy Lynn is on my dream team because she is an absolutely incredible ventriloquist. Why do you want to be back here?
Well, I've come back to show the new side of me. I'm now 19, and so it's like Darcy 2.0.
Are you going to tell me? What are you going to do?
I don't want to give it away.
What is it?
You just I can't tell you. I can't.
But why can't you not tell me?
I'm known for my ventriloquism, but there is more to me than just a ventriloquist.
Stand by, folks.
America choosing me as one of their favorite acts to come back is a really big honor. I think it is a little pressuring, though. I feel like I have to, like, live up to what I did when I was 12. But I just don't want to be put into a box. And so for my performance tonight, I'm doing something different. I think people are going to be surprised.
OK, here we go.
Did you have a mentoring session with her?
Yeah. She didn't tell me the song. She wasn't telling me what the surprise is. So I couldn't even give my 2 cents in, like, so.
Wow.
Oh, the moment you've all been waiting for. Me.
Okay, Petunia, this isn't all about you. And plus, I'm 19 now.
I know. You're aging. I'm not.
I know, but I feel like I'm old enough to do this on my own now.
Oh, you're serious?
Yeah, I am. I feel like I've got the music in me.
Ain't got no trouble in my life. No foolish dream to make me cry. Well, when life get me down,
come on, Tonya.
I'm gonna take it the way that I found it. I got the music in me.
That you are absolutely fantastic. I'm glad you didn't abandon Petunia all the way because this is how we fell in love with
you. I felt bad for her.
I'm so happy also that you're back here on our stage. Thank you.
Mel, what did you think?
Your beauty is you and Petula's voice and your voice.
Petunia.
You know who I mean.
Petunia.
I can't even say Petunia.
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 And Petunia, yeah. That's what captured America's hearts. But I almost loved the simplicity of what you were doing back then. And I just feel like the music and everything else overshadowed what you're so good at.
I don't agree.
You know what? Dussie, I'm going to agree with Mel, and I'll tell you why. There are very few people in the world who can do what you do. The singing and the ventriloquism together is your, what I call USP, your unique selling point. And I think we were distracted away from what you do so brilliantly. The good news is, it's not down to us, it's down to the audience.
Thank you.
You took a really, really big risk in stepping away from Petunia.
It's definitely different, but it's just a new part of me, and that's why I did it.
Having raised teenage girls, it's also somebody who's 12 years old who wants to show another side. She doesn't want to be that little girl.
Into a bit of a comedy thing without all the lights.
I agree with you.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Well,
breathe.
She seems a little nervous.
Okay, ready, sorry. I'm back, and I've actually been learning how to use my magic to try and get free things, okay. You know, since I didn't win $1 million. Mel, you know all about how to get drinks for free, huh?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, excuse me, sorry. You need a drink as well.
Yeah.
I got you. Think of your favorite.
Whoa.
Cheers.
Is this?
Is it?
This is my favorite tequila.
Oh my God. And I have an espresso because I keep the energy.
Terry.
Yes.
Can I see your credit card, please?
My card? I feel like I'm at home.
Okay, thank you. Terry's credit card. We're gonna put it in the wallet, and I want you to put your hand on top to keep it safe. Yes.
Okay.
Now, Mel, I'm going to show you what got me here.
Go on.
Go ahead and say stop.
Stop.
Lock the card in your brain, and I'm gonna show everybody at home. Got it? Cool. Take the cards. I don't want to touch them.
Yeah.
This card represents you very well, actually.
Yeah, it does.
It does? You're a Gemini?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're born in May?
Yeah.
The fifth month, so it's a 5?
Yeah.
And you like diamonds? Because who doesn't? So it's a 5 of diamonds?
Yes!
Oh, that's good.
Go ahead and take the card out of the middle. Take the 5 of diamonds.
Where is it?
Take a look.
It's not here.
You spread them out on the table, are you sure?
It's not there.
It's gone?
It's not there.
Well, the only cards I care about are playing cards, and I always carry one with me at all times in my wallet.
No, it's
Terry.
Not.
I have my hand here.
No. Raise your hand up off the wallet.
Right. No way.
Shut up.
I'm diamond. That is amazing. That is amazing. That's my card.
If Mel B's 5 of diamonds is in the wallet, then Terry, your card is missing.
Yeah, where?
Where is your card?
Oh, I'm gonna need that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What is the first thing they tell you to do when you lose your credit card?
Call them.
Yes, you call the bank and you tell them to freeze the card, right? So I've already gone ahead and frozen your card for you. No, okay. Literally. Literally, your card is frozen in ice in front of you all this entire
time. Stop it! No! 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 It's there!
Oh.
It's there!
What?
Are you joking?
Wait, there's only one way to find out, and I brought my special magic wand with me. Terry, can you really confirm that that is your credit card?
I'm going to confirm this right now. Yes! That is my credit card! Got my name on it.
America, cheers! Drinks are on Terry. Thank you all so much for having me back.
Thank you, Anna. That was incredible, incredible.
Mel, you were right there. What do you think?
Oh, my God. You are brilliant. And the tequila's got me a little bit, but you are great.
I did that on purpose, because the more you drink, the better the magic will get.
Simon, what did you think?
Well, look, she's that good that she nearly won the entire series.
Yes. Yes.
And you did it in your own unique, cool way. We have some incredible magic tonight, but I really genuinely hope that the audience get behind you and put you through to the next round, because you deserve it.
Thank you.
Hello, judges.
Hello.
Hello, beautiful.
This is Aidan Bryant.
He was your first pick, wasn't he?
Yes, he was my first pick. He has won before. And first of all, I love that you're back because you want more.
Yes, absolutely. I'm a competitor, you know, and I want to prove some stuff tonight.
When I won AGT All-Stars, it truly was the best moment of my life.
Aidan Bryant!
In that moment, it felt like I was standing on top of the world.
You've just won All-Stars!
I am completely self-taught. From a small kid practicing in my grandmother's backyard into now on the biggest stage across the world.
This is exactly what we're looking for on this show.
I didn't think it was gonna go this far, but now I'm starring in the biggest show in Las Vegas. So when I found out America chose me as one of the favorite acts, I knew I had to come back and defend my title.
Oh, yes, okay.
Oh,
all right.
Heidi has chosen Aidan Bryant.
That's not fair.
Aidan Bryant is a first-round draft pick.
Hello, Heidi.
Hi.
When I found out I was on Heidi's dream team, I was so excited. I would take any advice from her.
I keep thinking of the story that you told us, that you learned how to do this in your backyard at this tree.
Oh, my goodness.
If we could resemble this somehow on the stage again and kind of bring this story back so that there is more of a story to it.
Perfect. Okay.
All right, here we go again.
Hello. Yes.
All of my performances in the past has prepared me for this moment. Now, I'm ready to go down in AGT history by winning the show not once, but twice.
It's the golden buzzer today, and that's why I'm very nervous.
Oh, making me nervous.
Uh-oh. Somebody could get taken.
Oh, so you wouldn't want to be on Simon's team, right?
I would want to stick with Heidi, you know?
Did you hear that?
Absolutely.
I want to kiss you right now.
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
God, I'm just being dumped every week.
Again?
Oh, good luck.
Thank you, Simon.
He does not want to be with you. You heard it. He doesn't. Even if you push that buzzer, he doesn't want it.
See, if I was you, Simon, I would press it right now, quickly run up and mentor him.
Don't give him an idea.
Sky is
fantastic.
It's amazing.
You know, you see these acts and they do a few tricks and you think, oh yeah, great, where you are just endless and smooth and it's seamless and it's so graceful. It is perfection!
You know, it's a real testament. This is a show where only one act can walk out with $250,000. And your performance, I think, moved you one step closer to $250,000.
Aidan, honestly, you are a natural-born performer. It reminded me watching the Olympics sometimes, and someone gets a 10, a 10, a 10, a 10, and that was a 10. Actually, it was an 11.
I hope not.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you for having me back.
If you only wanted to be on my team.
He does not want to be with you, Simon.
Okay. Anyway, my respect for you for coming back and literally putting your title on the line. That says everything about you, and good for you.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it. Thank you so much, Simon.
Is you'll be staying with your mentor.
I was worried you were gonna steal him from me.
That was great.
I'm so happy I still have him.
We started saying it back in 2020. I had this idea, what if we took gospel sound and we put it to everyday music? And we were like, boom, here you go, world.
I loved everything about this. This was what we were looking for. Brilliant.
I knew that we were onto something special.
The act leaving the competition, sainted.
When they told us we were going home, that was quite a blow for us. Some members of our group came home to eviction papers or being fired from a job.
We could dwell with the losses and amongst the bad times. But crying versus laughing,
right.
Some people like to, you know, that's, I like to laugh. And we want to go to that part of life
right.
Where we are triumphant.
I was shocked when they didn't make it through to the finals. I wanted them on my team.
Thank you, Simon. Mm-hmm. We love you.
The first thing I said was, we've got to get you the best song in the world.
And I thought, it has to be Purple Rain.
I don't know if I can get it, but I'm gonna try.
5, 6.
I mean, I instantly begin to get visions. Like, I see it, let's do it. We have this amazing opportunity because Sainted is back.
We back, baby.
And we're ready to show America a different side of ourselves.
Yes.
So y'all know we have this thing with clearance and we need to get permission for a song.
We have to prepare for the possibility that Purple Rain is just not going to clear.
It never clears.
It never clears.
Never.
It doesn't clear.
I'm not going to let go of this. If you believe in this and you want to do it,
then I'm going to somehow make this happen.
We need to prepare two different songs just in case it doesn't clear. It's the night before we're supposed to perform.
We still don't have a final song. It's...
I know y'all don't know what to expect, because I damn near don't even know what to expect.
Hold the press!
No!
Okay, we have an update. So Prince's estate has been gracious enough to make an exception and give you permission to perform Purple Rain.
It's the 40th anniversary of Purple Rain. It's like, okay, we have to honor Prince, the legend.
Back again, back again.
And this is different from what we already did yesterday?
Yes.
But we gotta do it as quickly as possible, folks. We do not have a lot of time.
Simon fought for us. This is what we've been waiting for. The dream is to dream bigger.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You know, I know for a fact that that young man at the end of the table was up till midnight clearing that song.
Thank you.
We asked people on this show to step it up. You just stepped it up beyond. It was amazing. I'm so proud.
Let me know.
Mel.
I really don't like you. I really don't.
That's it.
They were brilliant! All right, all right, all right!
Simon knows what's up.
I just connected with you from that first audition. Then we spoke on the phone. And I said, how would you feel about singing my favorite song of all time, Purple Rain? And I just heard this scream.
Aww.
And I thought, that's a yes. I think Prince is the greatest artist of all time. And you said it was going to be good. It wasn't. It was incredible.
Yeah.
It was, honestly, a moment I will never, ever, ever forget. And I really pray that this moment will change your lives. And I'm going to give you something from my heart.
Oh, my God. That's something beautiful.
Beautiful.
this mean to you right now?
I remember being a kid rehearsing in the mirror, pretending that we were before crowds like this. Never stop believing, always keep dreaming. You can do it, you can make it.
One more time for fainting.
Now that we have the golden buzzer,
yes,
we are out to win it all.
There's only 5 spots left. Who wants to go next?
That was great.
That was really good.
Right?
Tonight, I'm a huge fan, and I've been following you guys for a long time on social media.
Thank you.
You always put a smile on my face and everybody's face, and I think at this time in our lives, nothing is more important than putting a smile on anybody's face.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Heidi?
I think all of you are absolutely adorable. I love the comedy within the dancing. I love when you break it all down and it's like slow motion, everything. It was beautiful. Thank you for that.
I'm just gonna say what I think everybody in the audience is thinking, which is you are just brilliant. Seriously brilliant. So talented. You work hard for this. Winning is important to you. Thank you for coming all this way. It means a lot.
I love you guys. Feed Mel B.
That was great.
That was really good.
Okay, your fate is now in the audience's hands. Good luck, guys, okay? Thank you so much. Thank you.
Do you follow them?
No, but I want to follow them now.
Welcome to our Las Vegas party suite. If I look around, it looks like we had a crazy night last night.
Yeah, because we celebrated a very special day. May 31st, 2016.
The date of our very first audition on America's Got Talent. And thinking about it, it just feels like it was yesterday.
Speaking of yesterday, I have no memory of what happened at last night's party. Do you, judges?
No.
Okay, Amelie will try to reach into your minds to find out what we did last night.
I have to put on this blindfold because that helps me get focused.
Simon. There are a bunch of different VIP cards and lanyards from Vegas attractions. We want to keep things random, so just take one of the strings, anyone you like.
Okay.
Yes, take it. Don't say what it is, just look what you've selected.
Oh, God.
Cover it with your hands, concentrate on it, and send your thoughts to Amelie.
Yes, I remember now, Simon. You insisted on going to this very special show, and that one was called Vegas Dark Divas.
Vegas Dark Divas.
It is Vegas Dark Divas.
Wow.
Great.
And Mel B, I kind of have the feeling we had something to eat last night. At least that would explain all these menus on the table, like here, burgers, Thai, steakhouse.
Yeah.
Just make it random. Just point to any menu, whatever you like.
Check it out.
Yeah. Select one of the food options on there. Howie, come a little bit closer.
Okay.
Show Howie and myself just with your finger what you have selected. This?
Okay.
Don't say it. Amelie?
Okay, Mel B, I think you went kind of for a breakfast. I guess something like fruits. You went for the raspberry yogurt parfait.
Yes, raspberry yogurt parfait.
It is.
I saw that.
Yeah.
Howie, what? You see all these room keys on the table.
Okay.
Confirm, all room numbers are different, right?
It seems that way, yes.
2129. Let's take some. Put them inside here. I will look away, reach inside, and just take one room key. Not
okay.
two. You
I've
have
got,
one.
I've got one.
Hold it against your body.
Howie.
What?
A pretty clear picture comes into my mind. Because yesterday night, we were walking around the casino, and you were wearing a bathrobe.
I was?
Oh, there's Howie's bathrobe. And Heidi, can you do me a favor? Can you read out loud what it says inside?
Do not remove from room 120.
Howie, for the first time, what room have you picked?
No.
120.
It is room 120! Here, you get your rope back. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But wait a second. All the random selections you made are associated to numbers. Mel B, let us know what is the name of the restaurant you picked.
Cafe 53.
Howie's room is 120. And Simon, can I have a look?
You may.
You're sitting in row 1, seat 6. Because Heidi, I remember you did heavy gambling last night and you won. Can you remember?
No.
You
no. can't, but oh. Heidi, I do have the proof because you won $53,120 and 16 cents.
Like Mel B's cafe, Howie's room and Simon's row and seat.
Oh, it's like all the numbers.
I'm so sorry, Heidi. We already spent all that money what? On this. Everybody, stand up. Try and catch a bill.
Because on the bills, you will see the faces of the judges. Mel B's holding her menu from Cafe 53.
Howie has his room number 120.
Oh, and Simon holding his show ticket.
How is that possible?
That's insane.
There is a reason this all happened.
It all started on one day, May 31st, 2016. You remember the day of our audition?
Yes.
Everyone, have a close look on this check.
May 31st, 2016. Thank you so much.
Thank you, America. Thank you, judges.
Thank you.
Who are you?
We are a boys band.
We are
Chubby Chappelle.
We watched America's Got Talent for years, and our first audition, we are so excited.
3,000 yeses.
And you're going to the live show.
We were so nervous.
You gotta hit some of the notes. They were really off.
We did not do our best singing that night.
Hello?
Melby?
We wanted second chance, and now...
Welcome to my dream team.
We have one.
Melby! I'm from a girl group. They're the ultimate boy band. I mean, it's a no-brainer.
And we are so excited to learn from her.
It's actually complicated choreography that you do. It's not like Spice Girls just did that a lot.
Yeah?
I did the choreography. Oh, cool.
You did. I love these guys.
Really?
Yeah, it's my cup of tea.
We have been training, we have been practicing. We want to show how much we improved and make Mel B proud.
Hi!
Thank you.
Chloe, you pushed buzzer.
Oh, what is that? He pushed the buzzer.
Oh.
They worked at their craft. They're bigger and better than ever.
Because of me.
Yeah, because of you.
Go for it.
Go
we
for can't. It.
We want to see you perform.
Have fun.
Have fun.
Have fun.
They are hilarious.
So, I know.
If they're good, I'm going to take
no, them. Come on.
What's up, ACT?
I would love
Heidi.
That.
I yes, because yeah, look, I feel like you totally improved from the last time we saw you guys. I also love that you came back, you know, even though he buzzed you the last time.
To help
so
them.
I feel like that's very humble of you to be like, help you know
them.
What?
Yeah.
We're going to work harder and come back and show them. And I feel like you just did.
Yes.
Boom.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thanks so much.
Very cute.
No, Simon.
You're not the best singers in the world. That wasn't the best song I've ever heard.
Hey, come on, Simon.
He's so tough.
I was getting to the good bit. I love the fact that you are old school. And actually, every time you come on, it makes me feel happy. This
Thank
was
you.
Way better than the first audition we saw.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
How are you?
No, I don't want to know what he's got to say.
Here's the thing. It doesn't matter what I say because ultimately the audience has the choice. Yeah. The audience votes.
You are great. Team Mel B.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Look, they are what they are. I
Simon.
Mean, they brought that.
A little corny. Yeah,
no, I felt like that's it was... what I love.
I also love a little corniness, I do.
Hey, everybody. Our next act is not able to be here today. He is performing remotely in London. So are we able to talk to him?
Hi, Musa.
Hey.
Hi. Welcome. Oh, I'm disappointed that you can't physically be here because the paperwork to fly wasn't done on time, and I am so happy that you're on the show.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I met Musa on Britain's Got Talent. Could you tell the audience here, please, you know, what you told us on that day?
My name is Musa Mota. When I was growing up, my dream was actually to become a professional football player. But at the age of like 10, 11, I got ill and I got diagnosed with cancer.
Growing up in South Africa was really an amazing experience. I had a very happy childhood, but when I got diagnosed with cancer, it was really hard. My dream of being a professional footballer was crushed. But dancing really made me feel brand new, made me feel happy, excited. when the music starts and then I'm on stage performing, nothing matter, you know? It's just me and the music and the stage performing for people. After my performance, it was crazy. It was like an excitement on another level.
The audience basically wouldn't leave the theater unless we gave him a golden buzzer, because we'd run out of golden buzzers. I'm not kidding.
We've got no golden buzzer.
We've got no left.
They pressed the golden buzzer, all of them at the same time. I made it to the finals, and then they announced, okay, and say, no, you didn't make it through. I felt a little disappointed, but since Britain's Got Talent, my life changed. Seeing myself on the news every day in South Africa, I felt honored.
Oh, he is here right now. Really a glorious moment for the country.
And then when I found out that I was Simon's first pick, I was just like asking myself, is this real? Him believing in me, I know I need to do my best. I wouldn't want to let him down.
Can I offer you one piece of advice? The only thing I was slightly disappointed when you were on BGT was I saw you with other people on stage, and I don't think you should have other people on stage with you. I think you are the star.
Tonight's performance is a second chance, but having to perform remotely makes me feel worried because I feed from the audience.
I think for you and the show, it's what I call unfinished business. You should have won the show, and you got every chance this year, I promise you.
I want to win people's hearts and show that nothing is impossible.
Look at all the hate they keep on showing. I don't wanna see that. Look at all the stones they keep on throwing. I don't wanna feel that. Like sun that will keep on burning. And I used to be so discerning. Oh.
Let me just tell you what's happening right now. There's about 1,500 people on their feet,
yes!
Some people in tears. Everyone's cheering. Even though it was remote, it was close. Honestly, I have so much respect for you as a person, as an artist. You are exceptional.
Thank you.
To think that somebody who loses a leg and loses the opportunity to play football would make their next choice dancing is so unbelievable, and you have reached such heights, and there are people with twice as many legs as you that don't come close to what I just witnessed right here.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Can I just say, I went to dance college. I trained as a dancer, and I didn't have half as much control or technique that you have. Hopefully, you've opened up the door so more of this. We see more of this. We need to see more of this. Yeah. And you do it so elegantly. And you're really cute. You're gorgeous. Flawless and gorgeous.
Yes?
I'm so proud of you. Congrats.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, actually.
He's great.
He's amazing.
He is.
Even remotely, it was amazing what came through the screen from so far.
The vote is coming up next.
This is going to be really bloody tough.
I discovered magic 7 years ago. I saw magicians on America's Got Talent. That really inspired me to get into magic myself.
Yes, Oscar, yes!
Killian was diagnosed with autism. He just didn't engage with the other children, and we just knew ourselves that something wasn't right. It is hard. But when he discovered the magic, it was like a light switch.
That is amazing.
Oh, my God.
You are unbelievably talented.
Now, Simon, I want you to think of a magic word.
A dog.
Just to see him smiling and doing what he loves.
Dog.
It's just priceless.
The third place act, Killian O'Connor.
I was very proud of myself for making it to third place.
13-year-old Killian O'Connor joins us now.
I've had interviews on TV, radio, newspapers.
You are genuinely, I think, one of the best magicians we've ever had on our shows.
When Simon chose me to be on his dream team, I just couldn't believe it.
What I love about magic is that when I understand what the main story is, I think it makes it more special.
It really does.
Yeah. So my one piece of advice is tell a story and use great music.
There's a lot of magic here tonight.
It is. Yeah. Yes.
Us, Anna de Guzman.
Yeah. Like a lot of good magic, right?
Okay, here we go, guys, clearing stage.
There is a lot of great competition here, but I really do think I have a chance of winning. I'm gonna put up a good fight.
With words, we can paint the world with kindness and create magic in everyday moments. Simon, the last time we met, I asked you to think of a magic word, which you wrote down on this hanky. Your magic word, dog. I'll leave it here. Now, I know you hate card tricks, but don't worry. It's not one of those. I've written some random words on the back of these cards. Take this half and mix them up whilst I mix these. Howie, please, say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
Read whatever is written on the back, but don't let me see.
Okay.
Simon, in a world that's often upside down, there's a chance for fun and happy moments to pop up when we least expect them. Let's bring our two halves together as one so we can find joy in this chaos. What if we could create a special moment of magic by making these mixed up words rearrange themselves to tell my story? Impossible, right? It's done. Forget what we're told before we get too old. Show me a garden that's bursting into life. Simon, I'm here because of you.
Oh.
Thank you. Okay. Howard, I asked you to choose a card which was the...
Nine of Spades.
The Nine of Spades. Let's try this. You know, Howie, only those who believe in magic can truly find it. Watch very, very, very closely. What was the word written on the back of the card that you chose?
Believe.
What? Now, Simon, show everyone what's written on the hanky.
Believe.
Changed.
My teacher, Mrs. Kirwan, always says, if you truly believe, then anything is possible. I used to be on the outside looking in, but now I'm on the inside looking out.
You know, this show, AGT and all the GTs around the world, are all about diversity. Anybody from any walk of life should be able to compete and have their dreams come true, including neurodiversity. And yeah. You are truly amazing, not only as a magician, but as a human being.
Thank you very much.
Heidi.
It was really, really great. It is a real show. And not just like a little act. Like, we could watch a whole show with you. Well done, young man.
Look, I've seen a lot of magic on the shows over the years, and I think you really, really have something special about you. You're 14 years old, and you've come all the way, thousands of miles, to come up with something so incredible. Just blew my mind. I really love you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
May God bless and keep your ways. May your wishes all come true. May you stay forever young. Forever forever young.
Heidi.
I think your voice is extraordinary. And when you let loose and it just goes, it's amazing.
Simon?
Look, Brian, you know what? I think you are a great singer. Would I have chosen that song? No. No. Did you have any input?
Not on the song choice, so but we did.
You
can you just shut up a second? We did talk about how to bring it back. See, I'm going to throw this water on you. It was telling me to do that.
Yeah. No fighting,
we
family.
We did talk about how we wanted to bring it back to just you and your voice. And I think you did that. The audience just has to vote for you. They have to.
Thank you. Thank you all. I love you.
Thank you. Love you too.
I'm feeling a little bummed, but what really matters here is what the audience thinks, and I have so much more I want to show them.